Hi guys, welcome to my channel. So today let's discuss some important common blood tests which doctors commonly advise, which helps in diagnosis as well as prognosis. So regular blood testing is one of the most important way to keep a track of overall physical well-being. So let's begin. So how often you should get routine blood tests done? So basically once a year, but if you are experiencing unusual persistent symptoms like fatigue, weight gain or weight loss or any new pain, you can do. Also, if you want to optimize your health, that is knowing your cholesterol level so as to make changes in your diet and to minimize the unhealthy habits, you can get yourself investigated. Also, after a certain age, risk of disease increases, so regular blood test can catch the warning signs of almost any diseases. So many heart, lungs and kidney conditions can be diagnosed using blood test. So the most common and frequently advised test by doctors are common blood count, which is also known as CBC, which includes red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets, hemoglobin and hematocrit. So, abnormal level of this component may indicate nutritional deficiencies such as vitamin B6 and B12 deficiency, iron deficiency, bone marrow issues, tissue inflammation, infection, and also cancer can be detected. So, the second test being the basal metabolic panel, which includes glucose, glucose being the most important indicator of a diabetic patient. Second comes calcium, sodium, potassium, bicarbonates and chloride. Kidney test, which includes blood, urea, nitrogen and creatinine. Their level increases if the kidney function decreases. So, abnormal results may indicate kidney disease, diabetes, bone issues, muscle weakness, abnormal heart rhythm and also abnormal blood pressure. Moving on to the next test, which is liver function test, which is advised to the patient when there is symptoms of jaundice, that is yellowish discoloration of skin, persistent nausea and vomiting, persistent diarrhea, abdominal pain, light colored stools and dark colored urine and also edema. And also it is advised to chronic alcoholic patients. This test includes albumin level, total proteins level, bilirubin, also alkaline phosphatase, alanine aminotransferase, aspartate aminotransferase and gamma glutamate transpeptidase. So this last four enzymes are only found when there is a liver damage. So abnormal level may indicate infection due to hepatitis virus, cirrhosis in chronic alcoholic patients, also gallstone mostly in females above the age of 40 years, or it may also indicate risk to heart. So moving on to the next important test, which is lipid profile. So your total cholesterol should be less than 200 mg per dl, triglycerides should be less than 150 mg per dl, low density lipoprotein should be less than 100 mg per dl, and HDL, which is high density lipoprotein, should be more than 50 mg per dl. HDL is a good cholesterol and LDL is a bad cholesterol. So the abnormal level may indicate risk to heart disease, stroke, diabetes and also high blood pressure. So moving on to the next test, which is thyroid function test, which is advised when there is gradual weight loss or weight gain, abnormal sleep pattern, abnormal heart rhythm, fatigue, weakness and also irregular menstrual cycles. So we check for T3 levels, T3 RU levels, T4 levels and also for TSH levels. So abnormal level like high level of T4 and low level of TSH may indicate hyperthyroidism. So the symptoms will be like fatigue, weight loss, amenorrhea, infertility, trembling of hands, muscle pain, hair loss, etc. And when there is low level of T4 and high level of TSH, it may indicate hypothyroidism. So the symptoms will be like weight gain, loss of appetite, constipation, menorrhagia, etc. So the last important test being C-reactive protein, which is made by the liver when tissues in your body are inflamed. So high level may indicate infections like pneumonia, sepsis, skin infections, chronic inflammatory disease like rheumatoid arthritis, inflammatory bowel disease and lupus, and also in heart disease. So higher the level, more is the risk of heart disease. So the normal range should be less than 1 mg/dL, but if it is from 1 to 2.9 mg/dL, there is an intermediate risk. If it is more than 3, there is a high risk, and if it is more than 10, it is an extremely high risk, and further testing should be done to diagnose high levels of inflammation in your body. Thank you. Hope you like this video and this video is helpful to you. Now you can interpret your own blood test report. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Bye.